you have been crying for and asking God for is as a result of family what? Idols.
Jesus.
There are women who are impatient and they are asking God for the fruit of the womb. Immediately they consult the wrong altar. The altar gives them a baby. They are satisfying like that they have a child already. But what happens is that that child becomes an idol. From one situation to another. It put the family in bondage. I've seen a man who traveled abroad. After reaching in abroad, he discovered that the man was from a Patosi land. He discovered that when he wanted to open his store shop, he saw his father's coat and cap. He saw his watch shop. Those were the things he never paid flight for. Those were the things when he was packing, he never carried. But when he got to abroad, the day he opened his wardrobe, he saw a traditional promo. He saw a cap. He saw everything the father was wearing. He said, yeah! He said, in abroad, this thing is happening. He took his phone and phoned the village. He said, Papa, what has happened? He said, I told you, you will come back.
Jesus.
Jesus. We don't know what they are cooking. We don't know what the enemy is cooking in our lives. We don't know what they are concocting in your family. You are crying looking at your children. You don't know who has composed them and put them where they are not supposed to be.
Jesus.
But the Lord is saying this hour. That is my time to rise and break the idols of the family.
Amen.
The idols of the family.
Let's go.
Idols get to the level where they torment you even in the dream
land.
Idols get to the level where they determine the future of your destiny. They determine the future of your children. These are not good things to happen to a child of God.
Jesus.
Libra Shamala Shaka. Israel. I want you to look at the book of Judges. Let's look at the book of Judges. We want to see if these things are in the Bible or they are not in the Bible. We want to see if they are in the Word of God or they are not in the Word of God. Judges 6, chapter 6, 27 to 29. That is the only thing we are going to read now. Judges 6. Who have seen the scripture?
Judges 6. Verse 6. And Israel was friendly.
Judges chapter 6. Verse 27 to 29. Judges chapter 6, 27 to 29.
Then Gideon took 10 men of his servant.
And then Gideon took 10 men.
And did as the Lord has said unto him.
And did as the Lord has said unto him. Amen. Which simply means that when Gideon was suffering, he never knew the cause of his problem. There are things we are crying and asking God, where? Papa, where? Where? Where can never give us freedom? There is no way a child of God will cry and say, where? Holy Ghost, where? Why is life like this? By the time you are crying, you say, where? God can never answer the prayer of where? So Gideon has suffered as a young man. And he cried, he thought of himself. He said, there is a history about my family. There are people that have history about their family that is missing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
At times you need to check about your family where you are coming from. Amen.
Amen.
You need to check about your history. There are people that have history of their family that is missing. And when you miss the history of your family, you miss your future. So Gideon looked at his history of his family. He said, my forefathers, Abraham knew God. My forefathers knew God. God answered the prayers of my forefathers. And then why is it that the promise God gave to my forefathers is not happening in my life if I actually belong to this family? And that is when he started calling on the God of his forefathers. is the Son and Daughter of God. While you are crying and asking God, where are you? He said, this is the time. I want to tell you what went wrong in your life. And I will not only tell you the mystery. I want to break even the mystery of what went wrong in your life. I want to break the mystery of what is happening now in your life. I want to reveal it and I want to redeem it. That is how he approached Gideon. And the Bible said Gideon took 10 men as instructed by the Lord. Keep reading.
And so it was, because he feared his father's household and the men of the city, that he could not do it by day.
Amen. He took the men and went. What was Gideon going to? He was going to destroy the altars of his father's house. And now he was afraid to go there within the day. He decided to go there at night, when no one could see him. There was a man that came one time from the land of Benway. He and the family, they could not sit together. The wife and him, the two of them, they were tigers and tigresses. Every day they were doing Jeli and Takishan. When they finished Jeli and Takishan, they entered Rambo. When they finished Rambo, they entered Chuck Norris. When they finished, they got to Left Musli. That is how their life was like. The woman will carry the man to the police and summon him. I want you to lock him up, he's an armed robber. The man will tell himself the next minute he takes the wife to that same police station. And they will lock the man, the woman up, he says, an armed robber. And they will go back home, they sit together to eat that husband and wife. And in the middle of the bed, they have put plywood to separate that nobody should touch each other. That was the reason where the enemy was doing. Because there was a God that was fighting this man. That man has struggled throughout his life. Life was not going. And he said, now I need God. He started looking for the record. And when he came to program, and the Lord had opened eyes, he said, son, look at these stones. The stones are crying from the land of Benway. He said, the family used to worship a God. And I said, sir, what does these stones mean? He said, man of God, there is a stone in Benway. We worship stone in our family. This God will never allow you to get married. This God will never allow your wife to settle. This God will never allow you to progress. This God will never allow you to go further. This God will take your money.